Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. Today, we start with a question. What do a potato, some Legos, and a loaf of bread have in common with Mount St. Helens? Mount St. Helens is actually a mountain and a volcano in western United States. And these three things, they're not volcanoes, but if you look at it and use your imagination, they kind of are shaped almost like small mountains. And the big idea is that scientists who make maps use special lines to draw these shapes on a flat piece of paper. Here I have a special map actually looking down on Mount St. Helens. Now, we said Mount St. Helens is a mountain. If I hold this map flat, I don't see a mountain coming off of the paper. Well, scientists use special lines drawn on a flat piece of paper so that I actually can tell it's a mountain. And we're gonna zoom in and take a closer look at those special lines and see how they work. So take a closer look at these lines. They stretch all around the paper, and these lines actually start further apart, but as I move in, the lines look like they're getting tighter and closer together. That has to mean something, and it does. So how do scientists draw these special lines on a map? Well, to show you that, we're going to use this loaf of bread, this mountain, this mini mountain made out of bread. And all I'm going to do is just start to take my bottom slice of bread, put it on a piece of paper, and use a marker to trace around that piece. Set this aside. Now, some of the slices of bread toward the middle are very similar in size, so I'm actually going to skip some of those slices, go down to my next slice, and trace it. Skip a couple more, trace it. Skip another one and trace it. Trace another one. And finally, the very top. Take a look at my map. So using this loaf of bread, we were able to draw these special lines that look an awful lot like the special lines on this map of Mount St. Helens. These lines actually show us the shape of the land. When the lines are really tight together, the land is steep. But when they're not as tight together, it's not as steep. Now keep in mind, we drew our mountain out of a loaf of bread. You can use other things. You can use Legos and pull apart each section and trace it on a piece of paper. You could use a potato, you could use a pepper, anything that's shaped like a mountain. I could actually break into sections, trace those sections, and draw that mountain-shaped object on a flat piece of paper and make a map. Scientists have a special name for these type of maps. They're called topographic maps. Now, let's take a closer look at Mount St. Helens. Now, we said that Mount St. Helens is a mountain and a volcano. Well, take a look at this. This is a picture of Mount St. Helens while it was erupting. Take a look at this. This is a picture of Mount St. Helens before it erupted, and this is a picture after it erupted. Can you see how the shape of the mountain changed? Here's a special plastic model of Mount St. Helens actually printed on a 3D printer. What's neat about this is I can see the shape of Mount St. Helens before it erupted, and I can see the shape of Mount St. Helens after it erupted. What's even cooler, if I look carefully, I can see those special lines we talked about in the beginning of the video. We've zoomed in and you can see those special lines as we look down our model of Mount St. Helens. Pretty cool. Now I'm going to take off the part of Mount St. Helens that was lost after the eruption. And notice you can still see those special lines in our model. You can even find your own topographic map of Mount St. Helens. Just go online and Google it. Remember, you can turn any three-dimensional shape into a topographic map. Who needs Mount St. Helens when we have a mountain of laundry? Take a dirty pile of laundry and try to turn it into a topographic map. One little hint, don't include your dirty underwear. It smells really bad. We'd like to thank the Thingverse community for their plastic model of Mount St. Helens. And if you would like to learn more about earth science and topographic maps, check out our links in the video description. Science is so cool. Thanks for watching.